What's going on, YouTube? This is the Jake channel, or Jake Mr. Green channel. I'm taking over for him. He's busy watching Gridiron football, and he wants me to talk about a plethora of things today. He wants me to tell you the football scores that happened. So, that worldly holiday Thanksgiving in the United States of America, but Bears beat the Lions 24-20, the Bills beat the Cowboys 26-15, the Saints beat the Falcons 26-18, and today the Broncos beat the Chargers 23-20, Rams beat the Cardinals 34-7, Ravens beat the 49ers 20-17, Buccaneers beat the Jaguars 28-11, Packers beat the Giants 31-13, Chiefs beat the Raiders 40-9, Redskins beat the Panthers 29-21, Steelers beat the Browns 20-13, Dolphins beat the Eagles 37-31, Titans beat the Colts 31-17, Bengals beat the Jets 22-6, and right now, the Texans beating the Patriots as I'm making this video, 21-3. Tomorrow is the Vikings at Seahawks, and I will go over the college football scores because, again, I'm Watchtower God. I know what you want. I know you want football scores. Okay, so the top 25, let's talk a little. On Friday, Boise State beat Colorado State 31-24. Virginia beat Virginia Tech 39-30. Iowa beat Nebraska 27-24. Memphis beat Cincinnati 34-24. Appalachian State beat Troy 48-13. Oklahoma beat Oklahoma State 34-16. Ohio State beat Michigan 56-27. Clemson beat South Carolina 38-3. Georgia beat Georgia Tech 52-7. Auburn beat Alabama 48-45. Wisconsin beat Minnesota 38-17. Wisconsin over Minnesota 38-17. Baylor over Kansas 61-6. Pennsylvania State, Penn State for short, beat Rutgers 27-6. Oregon beat Oregon State 24-10. Notre Dame beat Stanford 45-24. Louisiana State 50, Texas A&M 7. LSU for short, so LSU beat Texas A&M 50-7. The A&M stands for Agriculture and Mechanical. Kansas State beat Iowa State 27-17. Utah beat Colorado 45-15. Florida beat Florida State 40-17. I also have a present for you. Just bear with me. The population of planet Earth as of now is 7,614,670,000,000, or 7,614,670,000. And how many Jehovah's Witnesses are in the world? We gotta figure those physically in, mentally out, are gonna be destroyed and annihilated by me, actually gonna be annihilated by my, I'm gonna lead it, I'm gonna have Jesus Christ and his angels and, Tony Morris and Stephen Lett murder them. So, again, looks like only 8 million surviving 7,600,000,000, right, as of now, let me do the math. It's like 7,607,000,000 or 7,608,000,000 will be annihilated by heavenly forces. So you need to get to the Kingdom Hall and worship and have blind faith and just choose it. Just get to the Kingdom Hall. You don't, I'll murder you. And you have to actually, exert yourself to get there. You're going to be rejected a bunch of times when you try to file for reinstatement. You see, that's eventually going to happen. That's just, it's just the way it is. You're going to be destroyed, and I will murder you. if you don't follow these steps. It's going to take a long time for you to reinstate. So if you actually come back and my wrath comes and you're just ready to get reinstated, God, I will murder you anyway, because I am a God who can do what I want. I am Jehovah. I'm the Watchtower God. So, I also wanted to talk to you about other religions out there, and other, not even just Christendom, let's say, other religions like Buddhist or Muslim or Hindu. I'd like to share these things with you. Like the Vedas, it's a sacred text of the Hinduism. And I want to read them for you, and you'll really, again, I'm the Watchtower God. I can confuse people, and I can, the real reason is these religions out there is I throw them out there so you can be deceived. And if you're born in them, yes, then I'll help you. However, if you're a part of a different faith, obviously I'm going to murder you. You could be very sincere, you could be a very good person, and I will eventually murder you. Again, I will, again, murder you. So I can do what I want, and you're going to listen to these videos, because it's very important. Well, not really, but you know, whatever. I want to go over the Vedas. The Vedas, there are four Vedas. The Rig Veda, the Sama Veda, Yajur Veda, and Atharva Veda. I think I'm saying that right. I can't even pronounce my name correctly. I just don't know if it's Yahweh or Yahovah or Java or Yehovah or whatnot. So if I'm reading this incorrectly, I apologize. Again, like I say, the Vedas are the primary texts of the Hinduism. They also had a vast influence on Buddhism, Jainism, and Sikhism. Traditionally, the texts of the Vedas were covalent with the universe. Scholars have determined that the Rig Veda, the oldest of the four Vedas, was composed around about 1500 BC. Aha, that's negative. But it's BCE. BCE. And codified around about 600 BCE. It is unknown when it was finally committed to writing, but this probably was at some point after 300 BCE. And just to be fair, the world is now adapting to the BCE and the CE. And, since my organization should be no part of the world, I think we're going to have to change that. And, it'll be new light, of course, so it'll be flip-flops. And I just get tired of people thinking that just because I lead this, I give the food to Jesus, he gives the food to the faithful and discreet slave, like Toni Morris. You know what? It's not going to be perfect food, okay? Alright? I mean, I give it to Jesus. Jesus gives it to the faithful and discreet slave, the organization. Hey, the track records aren't great, but where else were you going to go? What other religion out there is the closest to the Jehovah's or the Yahweh's or the whatever they pronounce my name? I don't even know anymore. Anyway, back to the sacred text of the Vedas, however you pronounce it. The Vedas contain hymns, incantations, and rituals from ancient India, along with the Book of the Dead, the Enuma Elish, the I Ching, and the Avesta. They are among the most ancient religious texts still in existence. Besides their spiritual value, they also give a unique view of everyday life in India for 4,000 years ago. The Vedas are also the most ancient, extensive texts in Indo-European language and as such are invaluable in the study of comparative linguistics. Yes, like I say, I'm trying to get somewhere. I might be all omnipotent, but I'm just trying to find ways I can read this to you guys, and it's either on Amazon or, I mean, good grief, I'm just trying to find it, and it's just like, good grief, you guys should watch gridiron football. It's really a good sport to get involved in. It's very nice. You should. But I could read the Quran for you. You want me to read the Quran? I would, but I don't want this channel to get in trouble, probably, if you read the Quran. That would be not so good. Anything else I can do? I really want to make this video 20 minutes long. I think that's efficient. And that's how he's going to get some subscribers, Jake. He's going to have to get subscribers by, putting out content that's funny. Because people want to be, they have so much time in their hands. And they can listen to these XJW channels. And they can talk for 30, 40, 50, 60, a minute, an hour. 2 hours long, 3 hours long, and people will listen. People will listen to that. And that's the kind of, hello, Watchtower God, back again on Jake's channel. Yes, you probably wanted, I'm giving you spiritual food at the proper time. I'm going over the Buddhist text, scriptures and text. The Buddhist Society has a thing. You go to the BuddhistSociety.org. And it says right here in the scriptural text, oral tradition. The Buddha's teaching was oral. He taught for 45 years, adapting the teaching to suit the group he was addressing. And there is duplication in the text. The language he used is understood to be Magadhi. Again, I don't know. I'm not perfect at pronouncing words. After all, I can't even pronounce my name correctly. The Sangha memorized the teachings, and there were group recitations at festivals and special occasions. The teachings were rehearsed and authenticated at the first council and were handed down from generation to generation accurately by means of these group recitations. The oral tradition continues today. The Sangha chant selected texts at ceremonies, and sometimes the lay people join in. The chanting is considered to be sacred acts in addition to reminding and teaching the Dhamma. Pali Canon. The teaching was written down first at the Fourth Council in Sri Lanka about 25 BCE. See, aha! They have a correct BCE. Notice how the Hindus have BC, but the Buddhists, now that is a religion that I might not annihilate at Armageddon, or might not take away, the Buddhist. Because I think they're going to be, well, after all, I have to murder their people that are not my people, because I'm a loving God. And getting back about 25 BCE in Pala, the writings were, what countries are these? I mean, come on. Hold on, I think I got a prayer coming in. It's a prayer from a child. A prayer's coming in from a child. There's not two witnesses to the abuse. Oh well. Alright, I'll get back to the reading that I'm gonna have, okay? Anyway, the writing was in three sections, Vinaya, Padaki, Sudha Padaki, and Abhidhamma Padaki, following the visions of the councils, and is called the Tibetaki, Three Baskets. The Vinaya Padaki consists of the 227 rules of conduct and discipline applicable to the monastic life of the monks and nuns. It is divided into three parts and, in addition to the rules, gives accounts of the circumstances under which a rule was promulgated and exceptions of the rule. The Sada Paraki consists of the main teachings or Dhamma. It is divided into five Nikayas or collections. These are the long teachings, Digha Nikaya, medium length teachings, Mahayana Nikaya, groups of shorter teachings according to common topics, Samadhi Nikaya, a collection arranged to subjects discussed, Angadi Nikaya, and a collection of variety of shorter texts and phrase, in verse and prose. The Abhidhamma Pitaki consists of seven books called the Higher or Further Teaching. This is philosophical analysis and systematization of the teaching and seems to be the scholarly activity of the monks. The writing was on stripes of dried palm leaves, cut into rectangles and etched with a metal stylus and rubbed over with carbon ink. A thread was passed through the pages to keep them in order too, and elaborately the painted wooden covers fixed the ends. This is done even today, is considered to be a notorious activity. The Pali Canon has been recited, checked, and agreed at the councils. The whole of it has been translated into English. The Pali Canon was put on a single CD-ROM disc, which is published by the American Academy of Religion and Scholars Press in Atlanta, USA. Atlanta, Georgia, USA. When did they put that? Doesn't make any sense. Now I'll go and read about the Sanskrit Canon. The Buddha advised the monks to teach in the different languages of the people. The oral teachings continued in India in forms of oral Sanskrit. At the Fourth Council in India in the 1st century CE, the teaching was written down. Hold on, I got another prayer coming in. Another prayer coming in from someone about they think that the Jehovah's Witness organization is not the true faith. Hold on, I gotta retake this. Okay. Alright, I got this written. I gotta write down some notes. They're praying to me, they're saying, is this the true faith? They don't think the Jehovah's Witness organization is the true faith with the failed predictions. I guess I'll probably have to murder this individual. Yes. Okay. Sorry about that. Was a prayer coming in again on the Watchtower God. I'm a busy person. I have to, you know. Hey, I'm a god. You know, I can do what I want. So, I won't go into other detail. I can go into more detail. Let me talk about something other than I've heard this country called now. China. I'm gonna have to maybe do another video on that. Maybe next video I'll have to talk about China. Yes, I think I'll have to do that. Again, subscribe to this guy's channel. He's gonna be destroyed again soon, so hey, please do it. Thank you. Later.